Good morning. Have a marvelous Monday. Dear children, we are learning about the ancient civilization, and in ancient civilization, today we are going to see about Chinese civilization. Well, can you able to recall the other two civilization what you have learned earlier? Good. Egyptian civilization and Mesopotamian civilization. This Chinese civilization has been flourished with the two rivers. Along the two rivers, that is Huanghe, and the other one is River Yangtze. That's why it's also called as River Valley civilization. Why do these civilization has been flourished along the river valleys? Because people hardly need water for their survival. For food, for washing, for cultivation, even for the cattle's well. River Valley civilization is very, very important, and throughout the world, the civilization has been flourished along these river valleys. Okay, we'll continue the lesson. In China, River Huanghe and River Yangtze has tremendous of water. It has been said that of about 70% of the economic growth comes through this river valley civilization. Here we see Huanghe River has been given two other names. One is Yellow River and the other one is Sorrow River. Yellow River. During the flood, the slush, the mud and all the crush, the seeds, everything rushes along this river and it gushes out of the place also. That's why the color gets changes and turns to yellow color. That's why it's called as Yellow River. And when the flood increases, you know the meaning of flood. The flood causes heavy damages for the life and property. That's why the people face crisis. It's called as Sorrow River. And in these river valley, the Neolithic villages, the communities, the city-states existed in China. We'll see about the politic condition. We'll see some of the pictures over here with both the rivers, the course of river, the flood gushing out. The Yangtze River by the right side, it is also called as a Three Gorges Dam, which has been constructed across these river. We have the bridges running over there, and it is a very good scene to view the river from the bridges, and it also attracts some of the tourists around the world over there. Well, move on to the polity and emperors. We have many of the emperors have been ruled over China during the early period. Among them, the main emperors have been found by the Qin dynasty, the Chou dynasty and Han dynasty. Among these, today we are going to see about the Qin dynasty. The ruler of Qin dynasty or the founder of Qin dynasty is Shi Huangdi. He was the first emperor. He has been given as title the Son of Heaven. That's why Shi Huangdi is also called as Son of Heaven. His period is known as Imperial Era in China. Imperial, superpower, with a good ruling. He has defeated all the feudal lords. The land was under the feudal control. He has defeated them and got back the land and given to the peasants. He has established a strong empire. And he also has been constructed the Great Wall of China. He has demolished all the fortified walls in the country. And he has constructed a single wall to avoid the invasion from the Mughals, and it is called as one of the wonders of the world, the Great Wall of China. It was also called as one of the seven wonders of the world. It has been constructed by Queen Shi Huang, that is Shi Huangdi, between the period 3rd century to 17th century, of about 20,000 kilometers throughout the hills and plains. It's purposefully constructed to protect China from the Mongol invasion. It is very well seen even from the satellites. Okay. We'll move on to next dynasty, the Han Dynasty. Wu Ti, the greatest emperor, have found this. And we have seen many emperors among the dynasty, but he was the one. Wu Ti was considered a good ruler. During his period, the history of China was written, and he also has undertaken many public works. Irrigation tanks have been constructed to develop agriculture. He is the one to open Silk Road. Why this Silk Road? The Silk Road has paved the way for the traders to enter into China, and it also moved on to other Asiatic and European countries. The Chinese silk is famous throughout the world. In those days, it is said that Chinese silk has reached Rome also through Tamilagam. Philosophy and literature. China is famous for philosophers. We'll see about that in detail. Some of the philosophers: Laertes, Confucius. Confucius is one of the person have found new religion called Confucianism. Mencius, Maiti, and Tao Chen. And these philosophers encourage the people against the prevailing social evils. They have given their ideas against the social evils, the superstitions, the belief. What were the belief of Chinese? They have believed in their soul. So a dead person who is around them will give them superpower. That's their belief. Philosopher raise their voice against all these superstitious beliefs. And they have got the society under their control and wanted to get rid of all these paths. We'll see some of their contributions. Santis, he was one of a military strategy, have written Art of Army, have given importance for army, wanted to get rid of all the enemies from their country. The second one we are going to see is the Yellow Emperor. He has written the Canon of Medicine. It has been said that this was the early written book for medicine. Laertes, he is also called as a master of Archies. He founded Taoism. He said that desire is the root cause for all the miseries. And it was one of the Buddha's thought also. Confucius, one who founded Confucianism, he was also considered as a philosopher and a reformer of the society. Mencius, he is a philosopher as well as the counselor. He has given counseling to the people. He also insisted that the ruler have to rule the country in a proper way, in a dignity manner, in a perfect condition. Confucius says that to regulate the personal life. Why to regulate the personal life? Because only through the personal life the person can change the nation. When the family life has been regulated, the society will be regulated. When the society is regulated, the nation gets regulated in a proper way. So through their ideas and visions, they were about to change the society. Their thoughts, their bad behavior, the belief. Thus, philosophers get a topmost among the Chinese civilization. The next we are going to see is Chinese script. They have a pictographic form of writing which has been in later period converted into symbol form. And a contribution of the Chinese to the world. They have given the written system. The script has been improved. They have invented the paper and given to the world. Opening of Silk Road, especially for the trade. Invention of gunpowder against the enemies. Thus, we end today's session. Thank you. We'll move on to the homework. Today, we are going to see the Chinese philosophy and literature. Children, mark in your book and learn. Also, learn properly. Look for the spellings. Post it today evening by 5 to 6. Shall we learn this? Read with me. Philosophy and literature. Chinese poets and philosophers such as Laertes, Confucius, Mencius, Mo Ti, and Tao Chen contributed to to the development of Chinese civilization. Sun Tzu, a military strategist, wrote the work called Art of War. The Spring and Autumn Annals is the official chronicle of the state at the time. The Yellow Emperor's Canon of Medicine is considered China's earliest written book on medicine. It was codified during the time of Han Dynasty. Laertes was the master archive keeper of Chou state. He was a founder of Taoism. He argued that desire is the root cause for all the evils. Confucius was famous among the Chinese philosophers. He was a political reformer. His name means Kung, the master. He insisted on cultivation of one's own personal life. He said, if personal life is cultivated, family is regulated, and once family is regulated, the nation life is regulated. Mencius was another well-known Chinese philosopher. He traveled throughout China and offered his counsel to the rulers. Well,